everyone, and welcome to a very special episode of The Rift Effect. This week has been massive for all geeks out there with the release of Avengers Endgame, and this video is in homage to that movie. Basically, last year we were in a very similar situation with the release of Infinity War, and since then I have been absolutely obsessed with the Captain America Nomad Infinity War suit. Since then I've been wanting to cosplay it, and so for the past year I've been growing my hair, growing the beard, and saving the pennies to buy the perfect suit. And today, finally, in this box, which I've sneak peeked already at, it finally arrived. The suit is from White Sheep Leather, and they produce high quality movie replica suits, especially for Captain America. And from the cosplay forums, they are the best. So it took a lot of saving of money and pennies, but finally it's here. So this video is about going through the box, showing you the pieces, talking about each piece. So then I'll do a montage of me wearing the suit, showing the movability, how comfortable it is, and how well it fits me. And all going well, the measurements are spot on, and we'll have a really good suit which I will be presenting for the first time this Saturday, the 27th of April, at Cineworld in Oldham, where we will be doing our promotional event for Avengers Endgame, where I'll then, a little bit later than everyone else, be seeing the film myself. So, without any further ado, let's get into this box and just look at how good this thing is. So let's start with what's directly on top, which is the gaiters. I'm gonna put the boot going over my boots. Now the boots I'll be wearing, I'm ex-military and I've got some military boots that I'll be wearing, which are perfect. They look very much like Captain America's. The only thing they're missing really, I could wear them without the gaiters, but all of Captain America's suit really has the gaiters in them. Unfortunately, White Sheep Leather don't do Infinity Wars accessories yet, so they now do the, but they do the Civil War. So with some editing, these can be turned into Infinity War quite easily. So the gaiters are in black. They feel perfect. I don't know if you can see the detail in. I'm hoping you can see the detail on these and on the buckles on these. In fact, if we had some better light. You can see the buckles on the gaiters. Now to make them Infinity War, they probably just need a bit of weathering, done with a bit of sandpaper, making them look a bit more scruffy, some maybe brown shoe polish on them, some dust, dirt glued onto it or buffed onto it, just to make them more accurate to the movie. So they are brilliant. As you can see, they're quite big, these ones. I am a size 12, so they're quite a big size. Okay, so they're brilliant. So let's go on to next. So next thing is the gloves. Again, these are from Civil War. So these will need editing. I have, however, got another pair of gloves that I ordered from Wish. They're only a cheap set. However, the difference is quite obvious. So the Civil War gloves are these ones, which came from White Sheet Leather. Really nice glove. Done on a Velcro strap, as you see there. And they are quite tight to get on. But really comfortable. Already I can feel how comfortable they feel. Very easy to put on. But again, to be accurate, the strap would have to be changed to similar buckles. Everything would have to be weathered, made to look dirty. But to be fair, they're actually a really nice glove. However, I have got this other set from Wish. Oh, now I've got to try and get these off. Which are a bit more accurate. These have the buckles on the side that I was on about, and they're a bit more accurate to the colour already. They've already got that sort of weathered look about them. And these have a zip rather than Velcro strap. And again, these are really snug, but again, very comfortable to wear. The zip on the side is not great, but once they're zipped up, they look the business. They look accurate. They look great. So that's the gloves. I'll decide on the day which ones I'm going to wear with my suit for the cinema. Okay. Next is the harness. Now I went for the faux leather harness. Not sure if that was the right idea, the right choice, but that's what we've gone for. So there's the buckle, metal buckle, really nice. Faux leather straps. Now again, this is a Civil War, so the buckles on the straps are not the right ones. Luckily, however, I have ordered some from Etsy. They came in ages ago, so I will be changing these for the Civil War ones. I've already edited them, so they're perfect. I might do a bit of weathering on this, just involve a bit of black shoe polish, and again, weathering the straps with sandpaper, dusting them down, making them look like well-worn. Okay, next, we've got the belt. Again, from Civil War. So it will need a little bit of editing. Pouches are all functional and they look, they're great. They are really, really well done. Absolutely perfect. They have the little metal tabs on them. So the only thing really, other than weathering, that I'll have to do to this is change the buckle. And again, I got them when I ordered my harness buckles. I got the new buckle for the Infinity War buckle. So it'll just be a case of taking this one off, putting that one on, and it'll be perfect. I've already weathered all that and everything, so it's just literally take this one off, glue that one on. But again, the belt. Velcro, straps around the back. Nice and easy. Great, great piece. Looks the business. Can't wait to get this on. Okay. This is the main top. The main piece. And this is the bit I've been looking forward to opening. Oh wow. Wow, wow, wow. I'm hoping the camera's going to pick up all that detail. I got it weathered. So it's already weathered. So as you can see, the white is not as clean as it could be. It's got this sort of black dust paint. I'm just noticing now in the back, and I don't think the camera will pick it up, but actually the black dust paint is all in here, so this all looks like it's worn as well, which is brilliant. So even on the inside there, you can see it, and it's got the scales in there. Now I think on their original suits they didn't have the scales quite right, and they've updated them in recent months, and it looks brilliant. I love the scale pattern in that, and obviously then you've got the star chest symbol in the middle, and it just looks great. Wow. Now I've heard of people having issues with collars, so we'll discover if we've got that one, where the collar just comes away from the neck a bit in the movies, so we might have to try and pin that or get some Velcro in there and hold that in. But it's just gorgeous. Look at that. Stunning. The amount of detail. And it's not that heavy. This is a stretch fabric one that they do. This isn't the leather one. But it's great. It's perfect. Wow. Can't wait to try this on. So that leaves the trousers. main jacket, the under jacket. So, the trousers and under jacket are already attached to each other. Ah, that's why it makes no sense. Right, so, it comes in, big thing like this. And as you can see there, in this part here, you'll see the zipper to separate the under jacket from the trousers. And again, they've all been weathered already. I'm not sure the camera's going to pick this up, but it's all got that nice paint effect on them again to make it look dirty. The only thing that it could do with, that I might manage to spray on myself, is where the Avengers symbols have been come off his arm patches. So they might just need just a little bit of dirtying around here just to make it obvious that a patch was there at some point. So I might have to edit that. But again, feels very light despite all the suit being attached to each other. The trousers, again, all weathered. Might just need a bit of dusting. And again, a little bit of sandpaper just to make it look a bit weathered. Other than that, he is beautiful, absolutely gorgeous, and it feels great. Oh, it smells lovely. Ooh, love new smell, new stuff. Just beautiful. The arms, pads feel great. Just sitting in there nicely. So yeah, that is the full suit. Nice ventilation there, because if you're cosplaying, you could be in it for hours. I spent 3 hours at the Grand Prix last year in Hulk suit, in a Hulk's foam Hulk suit. Not pretty. So this will be good. So yeah. So what I'm going to do now is go get into this and leave you some footage of this. Please like, share, subscribe if you like this video. And I'll do more if you like this type of stuff. But I'll leave you now with some montage footage of me wearing it. Thanks, guys, and on that note, geek out. Showing how easy it is to wear, the movability in it. I'm sure.